Hello students, welcome back to our online class. So students, take out your EVS book. Take out page number 70. So in the last class, we have finished some of the portion. And today we'll study about the partition of Bengal and the Swadeshi movement 1905. So students, take out page number 70. To suppress the growing sense of nationalism and unity among the Indians, the British decided to divide the Indians on the basis of their religion. They divide the state of Bengal, which was the main center of the nationalist movement, into East Bengal for the Muslims and West Bengal for the Hindus. See, these Britishers were so clever that by seeing the nationalism and nationalism amongst the Indians, now the Britishers have applied a strategy to divide the Indians among themselves. And what was their strategy? Their strategy was religion. They decided that to divide the state and we should separate the Hindu and Muslim. The East Bengal for the Muslims and West Bengal for the Hindus. Okay. Now this strategy they have applied. The Indians strongly opposed the partition of Bengal, and as a result, Indians strongly opposed the partition of Bengal. The Congress started the Swadeshi movement in 1905. Now what do you mean by Swadeshi? Swadeshi means of one's own country. People boycotted the goods made in Britain and started using things made only in India. The British gave in, and in 1911 they reunited Bengal. As a result, now the concept of Swadeshi, okay, the Swadeshi movement came into force. Now what do you mean by Swadeshi? Of one's own country. Now the Indians started boycotting the things. Boycotting means to refuse to buy any product, okay, of someone's opposition. That means, who is the opposition here? The Britishers. They refuse to use any product by the Britishers. Then that is the meaning of boycott. People boycotted goods made in Britain, okay, and the Indians started using things which were made only in India. And the Britishers in 1911 they reunited Bengal. Activities of the revolutionaries. Several young Indians were willing to take up arms against the British and sacrifice their lives for the freedom of their country. They were called the revolutionaries. Now many youth they came in front to take up arms against the British, okay, and these persons were called revolutionaries. Now who were those? Baring Ghosh, Khudiram Bose, Chandra Shekhar Azad, Bhagat Singh, Sukhdev, Rajguru, Uddham Singh were some of the prominent revolutionaries which they fought for, struggle for India. Okay. The World War One and after the World War One broke out in 1914 and many Indian soldiers fought on behalf of the British. The Congress thought that this would make the British grant freedom to India. But instead, the British became harsher towards the Indians and imposed more taxes to recover the losses they had incurred in the war. So, in 1914, the World War had begun. By the time what happened, many Indians were working under the British. They were mostly soldiers. But what happened by that World War, these Britishers became much more harsh and they levied more taxes because they have killed so many soldiers to incur that loss. Okay, incur that loss, they imposed high taxes on the Indians. Now Gandhiji leads the nation. In 1915, Gandhiji came back to India from South Africa. It was Gandhiji who came in 1915 from South Africa. He was invited to join the Indian National Congress and join the struggle for independence. Mahatma Gandhi was invited to join the struggle for independence. Within a few years, he became one of the main leaders of the Indian freedom struggle. And as a result, Mahatma Gandhiji became the leader of the Indian freedom for struggle. He was loved and revered by Indian masses. So many people loved him. Under his leadership, the freedom movement spread to every nook and corner of India. So under his leadership only, this revolt spread to every corner of India. Okay. Now coming to the Rowlatt Act and the Jallianwala Bagh Massacre. As the freedom movement spread, the British passed the Rowlatt Act. Now, what is the Rowlatt Act? Rowlatt Act was passed by the Britishers, and in this act, the cases to be tried without fair trial. Suppose a soldier has been convicted, that means he is put to jail, but without hearing anything, without putting him trial, without hearing him that he is right or wrong, what did he do? So instead of going to this fair trial, they simply used to pass judgments. Yes, you will be in jail for 12 years, you will be in jail for eight years. Yes, you are sentenced for death without fair trial, okay, without any procedure. And that is called Rowlatt Act, which allowed the British to imprison, that means to keep in prison anybody they suspected. Even if I suspect, yes, he is guilty for this Indian freedom for struggle, yes, you put him to prison. So without going to any evidences, he is put to jail without trial. That means presenting the case for judgment in a court of law. Gandhiji responded by asking citizens to use satyagraha. Satyagraha means non-violent. That means without the use of violence, without lathicha, without lathis, without guns, nothing, no ammunition. So peace, that is a peaceful protest to fight against the British. Now thousands of Indians joins in the movement, that is a non-violent movement, which was led by Mahatma Gandhiji. A non-violent meeting, demonstration and rallies were held across the country. On 13 April 1919, several people gathered at the Jallianwala Bagh in Amritsar to protest against the Rowlatt Act. The British soldiers arrived there soon after and, at the orders of General Dyer, shot at the unarmed crowd. Many people died in the shooting. The country was shocked in protest. Rabindranath Tagore, the author of our national anthem, renounced the knighthood conferred on him by the Queen of England. Now, on April 13, 1919, there was a crowd at Jallianwala Bagh, okay, in Amritsar, to protest. Why the people gathered over there? To protest against the Rowlatt Act, which was passed by the British. But the British soldiers arrived at the order of General Dyer. That Dyer was the general of the British East India Company, okay. And every person with the gun. And there's many people that they thought how they can use guns to kill people without any cause, okay. Now in protest, now in that case, the Rabindranath Tagore, who is the author of national anthem, that is Janaganamana, he also renounced the knighthood conferred on him by the Queen of England. Now coming to the non-cooperation movement. So with the entry of Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose and Abul Kalam Azad into the National Congress, the freedom struggle entered its next phase. See, now Jawaharlal Nehru, Subhash Chandra Bose and Abul Kalam Azad, they joined the National Congress, and to change the scenario. The Congress now demanded Purna Swaraj or complete independence from British rule. So at that time, what they demanded? These members demanded only Swaraj, that means only self-rule. Now they demanded Purna Swaraj, that means complete freedom against the British rule. In 2020, Gandhiji announced their peaceful non-cooperation movement. People boycotted British goods and institutions. Men, women and children blocked the streets and refused to leave when they were beaten up by the police. Thousands were arrested, including Gandhiji. The movement was withdrawn by Gandhiji in 1922. In 1922, when it turned violent in some places, he strongly believed that the movement could be successful only through non-violence. So, in 1920, again one movement started, that is the non-cooperation movement. I mean, do you know what is the name of non-cooperation movement? Cooperation means what? We are cooperating with each other, okay? Suppose I am teaching you and you are listening, okay? That means what? You are cooperating me and that is why you are listening. Otherwise, you could have gone out of the class, isn't it? So that in the same sense, this the Gandhiji said that non-cooperating now, okay, that means not to cooperate with the British government. Whatever British government says, we will not obey their laws and orders. And that is why, that is what it is called non-cooperation movement. And that is why people boycotted. That means people boycotted British goods, then schools, institutions, men have left their offices, and children were protesting in the streets, and many of them were beaten up by the soldiers and taken to the prison, and one of them was Mahatma Gandhiji. And finally, and what happened in some places, this movement took a violent turn, and that is why Gandhiji was compelled to stop this movement in 1922. Okay, otherwise it would have been a successful non-violent protest. Okay students, so in the next class we shall study the civil disobedience movement and rest of the portion. Till then, thank you.